Hi, this is JP Morgan. Today on the Slant Lens, we're at a little town just outside of Austin, and we're here with a band called
Arc-Attack.
Arc-Attack, what do you guys do?
We use two giant singing Tesla coils to perform a musical act.
I think they're fabulous. I have been so personally enamored with Tesla coils forever in my life, and this is so exciting to me to be able to do some photographs where you see the lightning going off from the cage we have in the background. We see the lightning going into a suit that Joe's going to wear. That's going to be fabulous. We're going to have Carla in the cage behind us. And tell me why that doesn't electrocute Carla in the cage.
Well, short answer, it works a lot like a lightning rod on the top of the building. So when the lightning hits the lightning rod, it goes all the way around the building instead of through it.
Well, they let me join the band. I'm playing the triangle. And so
it's a gong.
But the challenge I'm facing here is that we've got a lot of different light sources on set. And so I want to be able to get the color that I'm seeing on set when I go back to the studio, and to be able to get that instantaneously and not have to get into Photoshop and be able to mess with it. So in order to do that, and I'm gonna give Carla and Joe my gong, triangle gong, and the spider checker becomes my constant in each one of the shots I'm going to do. I'll put it in at the beginning of each shot as we change the color, change the lighting, change the situation, and now I can use this as my constant. I will get the color rendition that I'm seeing here because I have just enough clean light in the front that it's going to give me the clean color that I need. And then once I go back into the studio, I can simply sample this. It's going to give me exactly what I saw here. We have strobes, we've got LEDs, we got LEDs from Lowe's, we got a strobe somebody dropped off in the corner. We got every piece of lighting equipment we possibly could find on the set. And all those different color renditions, we like the color and we want to see that color when we're back in the studio. So that's why we're going to use our spider checker. So anyway, let's get started and see what we can do. That's one mean triangle right there.
You're fired again.
Fired again! Dang! All right, so the way we've got this lit here is very simple. We've got a smoke machine in the camera left side. I brought that on the airplane with me with a gallon of fluid, and it flew just fine in one of the cases. So smoke machine on the left-hand side, it goes against the wall, and then the fan kind of blows it back into the scene. So the smoke is just like it's a beast of its own. It does its own thing, so we'll have some with heavy smoke, some with just mist in the shot. So smoke machine on the left-hand side, camera left side. We have a Baja camera left and a Baja on camera right. They both have blue gels on them. Then we have some stage lights here. We've got some LED stage lights, a green one on camera right and a red one on camera left. Now, in the background, we've got our two guitar players who have to stay behind that screen or they'll get hit by the lightning. So on them, we've got LEDs. They're just shop lights we had. We needed a little bit of light. I only flew with a few lights on the airplane getting here. So we got shop lights on them, one on each of them. They're hanging up on the grid. I'll probably retouch those out in the final images. So that's lighting their faces. Inside the cage now, we've got a small LED above that's gonna light Carla from above, and we've got a nice LED from below, which is going to give us a little bit of red on her legs and underneath. So she'll be in the cage while the lightning's hitting it. And we'll do some shots also with Joe and with John in a suit where the electricity can hit the suit and it grounds them out to the floor and just goes, and so it doesn't hurt them. So I'm excited to see that as well. And I want to get in and do a shot inside the cage. That sounds so cool to me. Anyway, so there's our lighting. Last light. There is a light behind us here. It's a Baja. And that just gives me a little bit of clean light up front here. And that becomes just a little bit of, it helps kind of clean the light up front. So we have just some clean light in the shot and opens up the shadows just a little bit. I almost forgot. We've got an Aperture 300D light right behind the cage that's going to give us a great backlight for the smoke and for our talent inside the cage. That Aperture 300 LED was a great light for this. So Carla is our model in the cage, and she's really here kind of substituting for the band because one of their members is not available. But Carla does a lot of really interesting things. So tell us about what you do and where they can see your stuff.
I'm a performance artist and costume designer now based out of Austin, Texas, and you can see my stuff on my YouTube channel or any other social media site at Carla X Official.
Carla X Official, so there you have it.
C-A-R-L-A X Official.
There you go, so check it out. shoot's over, so now it's time to go bowling.
We just went bowling with our SKB case. Literally, went bowling with the case. And camera's absolutely fine. Good to go.
So we just got back from Houston here, back here at the studio, and Jalene says that Texas has kind of worn off on me. I'm not sure what she's talking about. But anyway, let's talk about processing our images that we shot with Architect. Now, we used the spider checker in the images. We would put it like the first image of a new setup. I'd have the spider checker in. And the light that turned out to be the key light for our model was in the cage. This cage is made so the electricity can hit it, transfers through the cage and goes to the floor and doesn't hurt her inside. So actually, I got inside of it. It was pretty exciting to have the electricity hit in it. It was kind of cool. But anyway, so the light in there was just an LED they had installed at the top of this cage. It looked a little, the color didn't look great to me. So I got the spider checker in there, got a shot of the light that's going to be in the cage on her face. And I'm going to use that to just color correct her face and to make sure her face looks right. I do a very simple process with this, something that gets me quickly to where I want to go. Now, you can process in Datacolor's software, but in this process, what we're going to show is just going through RAW, Camera RAW, just a simple application. All right, so I'm going to open up one of the Camera RAW images here. You see in this shot that this is the way it was shot. Now, the light that's on her face, it looks off to me. There's no doubt about it. So I'm just going to simply go in. I'm going to select the white balance tool, and the second square, there's this row that goes from black at the bottom to the white at the top. Second one down is a gray color. We're going to click on that to correct the color in the image. It brought this thing way back. You see a lot more blue in the image. It's not so warmish, and it looks really nice. It gives us a nice skin color on her. If I accomplish nothing else with this, that's worth it to me, because I wasn't sure what color that light was above her head, and I wanted to make sure I got a nice color on her face. But now from here, you know that the square on the bottom needs to be at about 4%, so you want that to be pretty dark. So I may take the blacks and just bring them back just a little bit, make this a little more moody. I don't want to bring the whites up anymore. I know that they say, you know, white should be up in the 80s or 90s, like 93%, 94%. But for me, I want this pretty moody, and I'm not going to push the whites up here. If I push the whites up into that category, they're going to be way up in here, and this is going to be way too open for me. So I'm going to keep it back to about where it is. Now that gives me we've got a nice color. We've got, I like the exposure, I like where the blacks are at. And right there, I'm going to go ahead here and click on the image over here and save settings. I'm going to save these settings. I'm going to call this Arc, A-R-C, attack. Arc, attack! 3, and we're going to save that in our settings. And now I've got that set now. So any of these images I print or I process of her, I can just simply make that application through Camera Raw. So I just simply go up to the side here, apply preset, and there's Architect 3 right there, and I can apply that to all the images I process with her. I think this is super fast. It's in Camera Raw. I can apply this to a whole bunch of images at once if I want to. Just very easy to use. So we've got to take an image every time our lighting situation changes. And for me, when I went into close-up, I put the spider checker in. When I went back to a full body, I put the spider checker in. I put it in every time I made a change that was fairly large. And even though I wasn't really changing my key light, like this will probably work fine for my full body shots, but just to be safe, I've got a full body, I put it in the full body as well. So I'll probably just cancel out of this. These aren't the images I'm going to process. I'll go on to another one another full body here, just to see what we've got here. What's a little bit hard for me, and I'll make some adjustments a little later, but this is going to give me my color. So I'll go ahead and hit the white eyedropper here that's it says right on there, the white balance tool. I'm going to hit the second one down. I'm going to clean the color up. Now I need to open up the exposure on this one. It's just a little too dark. And I think that is good for what I'm doing. I'm going to crush the blacks just slightly. And I'm now going to do a new preset. Now let's go up to our preset. Let's apply our preset. Let's put our standing man on. And that brightened that up a lot. And this is now, in these kinds of situations where I'm using smoke, I just can't use a preset and apply it to everything. I know my color's correct now, but my exposure and things change because smoke changes on everything that we do. So I'm gonna go in, I'm gonna bring the exposure back a little bit. I'm gonna open up the shadows just a little bit. And I may even take and give me just a tiny bit of a clarity here just to sharpen up some things. So this is a process for me. I know the spider checker helped me to get my color correct on his face or her face. That's the starting jumping off point. Now I'm gonna go in with the exposure and I'm gonna play with them on each image because the smoke changes in each image. You'd have to put the spider checker in on every single image and you can't do that because the spider checker is in the shot on every image. So I'm just gonna have to go in now and make adjustments for the exposure and for the blacks. But for the color, I know that I'm on. I'm right on with the color when I use that preset. I make my final adjustments and I move on. So I think this is just a simple way to use this. Now, if you wanna take this information, this preset here, I can take the preset and export that image out as a TIFF with the spider checker chart in it. And now I can take that into Datacolor software. And in Datacolor software, we can go ahead and make a preset that we can use in Lightroom. So let's see how we do that. So I've opened up the spider checker software now. I can just drag and drop this TIFF that I've made. The TIFF that I've made that's got the chart in it, drag and drop that. There's my TIFF. I come up with a whole selection of color squares here. And so I just simply take and get these color squares so that they centered. So there you go. So at this point now, I have a couple options here. I can say this is a saturated preset. That's gonna change my color setting. It's gonna make it a lot more saturated. Not necessarily what I want to do. I'm gonna definitely go to a portrait, which is just a little softer, a little nicer kind of profile that's going to look nice for her face. And I'm gonna save this to Lightroom. And I'm gonna go ahead and save my calibration. I'm gonna call it Arc Attack number 5. And there you go. When I open Lightroom, right under here under presets is my Arc Attack number 5. So there we have it. I'll just go ahead and open up my Arc Attack number 5. And it brightens up that image just a little bit and makes sure the color is clean on his face. So that's just a way to be able to do your preset in Camera Raw and to be able to take it into the Datacolor spider checker software and then apply that back into Lightroom. Now you can do this whole thing in Lightroom. You can open it up in Lightroom. You can make your adjustments there. You can get your highlights and shadows and make a preset in Lightroom as well. We've done that in another video called Why Should I Use a Color Checker? So if you're interested to see how to do that, check that out in that video, Why I Should Use a Color Checker. For me, the process is not about Lightroom, just a little added tidbit there. For me, the process is getting into Camera Raw, getting my clean color and my key light, and now I'll make the adjustments for the images according to the smoke and things in the set, and that's gonna give me my final images. Fast way to get clean color and get to my final images as quickly as possible. So, back to Texas for a little flashback at the end of the shoot. So this has been a great experience. It's almost 10 o'clock. We gotta clean up and get out of here and get back to Houston. We're gonna be like 2:30 in the morning getting home, I think. So we better clean up and get going. These guys have been great. It's been fun to be here. It's been fun to see them with the Tesla coils. Like I say, I love Tesla coils. This has been really a treat for me. And it's been nice and hot here in Austin, that's for sure. So make sure you follow us, follow us, do all those kinds of things on the YouTube channel. We'd love to have you part of our community. So keep those cameras rolling, keep on clicking. Don't estimate alone. Don't stand out in the cold all by yourself. Trying to put together an estimate? Go to thuslanalens.com/estimating. I've got a digital download that will teach you everything you need to know. You don't have to be alone any longer. So you have a YouTube channel, correct?
Yes, we do.
So what is it?
It's Arc Attack, and the link is gonna be down below in the info.
So check it out, Arc Attack, like Arc and Attack, right?
Mm-hmm. That is correct.